It's my great pleasure to be joined by Trevor from EV Blocks today. Tell us all about EV Blocks.
So we make a precast concrete foundation for EV chargers, making contractors' life easier.
Okay, making contractors' life easier. Well, Trevor's an electrician. He's created a product that makes our life easier. Can you remind us of what the original problem was that you solved?
Absolutely. So with EV becoming more popular, there's more demand on contractors to turn installations around fast. And our EV charger bases do exactly that. You no longer have to build a set of shuttering up, pour your wet pour concrete, float it off, hope it don't get damaged overnight or frost or rain, or damaged when the shuttering comes off. And effectively, that shuttering goes in the bin anyway, so it's a little bit of a wasteful process.
Okay, and you've got to wait for it to dry, where your blocks turn up on site. And talking of turning up on site, they seemed a little bit easier to move around than the original ones. What's happened to your blocks in the last 12 months since I first saw them?
So the blocks have gone on a bit of a diet. We've got a new block being released later on this year and into early January 2022 that weighs 94.2 kilos. So two people can lift it out of the van and onto site.
Okay, so that again is going to speed up the process. And when we last spoke, you were suggesting that people were doing the civils in a wanna. So in other words, they might be installing 10 of your EV blocks and using maybe 5 of them as EV installs. Are you still experiencing that?
Yeah, absolutely. And we're seeing that more and more as people are looking to adopt EV over a longer time scale. So as Gary mentioned there, they'll take 10 blocks, fit 5 chargers, but they'll have those additional chargers later on in next year's budget or the year after.
Okay, and again, another thing that you've put into it, haven't you got 4 entry points into the block? So that even the blocks that aren't being used are being used as, say, drawing in points in order to get further up the run?
That's right, yeah. So it gives you good access to grab hold of the cables and pull them through, or if you've got a change of direction where you're at the corner of a car park, you can pull a loop out before re-entering the duct again. And it saves the need for loads of inspection pits. We've seen some installations with inspection pits behind every single EV charger.
Okay, and that's more work, isn't it? You've got to dig out the ground, you've got to put the pit in order that you can have that pulling in point. Another good point that you suggested as well was the plates on the top can be left as a dummy plate or can be used to install the post on it. What's the real advantage of those plates?
The main thing is that they're universal to all AC chargers currently on the market. So as technology changes, and if, say, for example, your client changes their mind 2 years down the line, no, we're going to go to this model, instead of having to rework all the civils, it's a new plate, change the post, and away you go.
Yeah, so the bit that's in the ground stays there. We just drop off that plate, we put a new plate on, perhaps drill some new holes, and we are away with another new post. Again, it's saving time, saving effort, and making electricians and electrical contractors' life a lot easier. We've installed them here, okay, and they're coming in as part of our series of a commercial EV install here at Lineside Studios, and you'll see that in the series as we install the EV blocks. Thank you ever so much, Trevor.
No problem.